Hello friends, welcome to Bash Tutorial. Today the topic which we are covering is how to configure NAT instance in AWS. Many people have written to us that if we can have a tutorial, small tutorial on NAT configuration in AWS. So I will be shooting this tutorial in two parts. In first part we will be creating public private subnet and launching the instance on those subnets. And in second part we will be creating a NAT instance and NAT security group and try to depict it practically. So if we want internet access for our instances in private subnet, so we obviously need NAT instances. So NAT instances are proxy to internet, so they will have the access to internet gateway, and then we can actually do our work which require internet access on private, but it will be behind NAT instances. So these are the things which we need for a NAT configuration to work: NAT security group, then route in a NAT main route table that I will depict practically, then disable source and destination checks. So now let's move to practical thing. So initially what we will be doing, we will be creating a VPC. So when VPC will be created, after creating the VPC we will be creating two subnets, public subnet and private subnet. So here so I am creating a VPC. So let's say I say my VPC 10.0.0.0-16. So I have created the VPC. Now I will be creating two subnets. One will be private subnet and second will be our public subnet, right? Let's say I want to create .1.0.4, so it will be 256. Then the second I will be creating the public subnet. So we will create two instances, one in private subnet and second in public subnet. So what is the difference between private subnet and public subnet? Private subnet will have no virtual internet gateway attached to it, and public subnet will have internet gateway attached to it. So we have created two subnets. Now we have created a VPC. Now we will be creating an internet gateway. IGW So we have created internet gateway. Now we are going to attach that internet gateway to our VPC. So attaching the internet gateway to our VPC, now we will be going to route table and create another route. So we will be giving that route name my route. So now we will be giving a different route to this route, which will be internet gateway route, so that we will attach it to a public subnet. So now we will be associating a subnet, which is a public subnet, to this route. So now everything which will be placed in this subnet will have internet access. So let's associate a private subnet with another route. Now we will be creating the two machines, one in public subnet and one in private subnet. So let's move ahead and create the two machines. For public subnet, we will be choosing Amazon machine. Then we will be choosing T2 tire micro. We will be choosing here public subnet, enabling the auto sign. Now we are launching it. So this machine will be having the internet access, and this is a machine in public subnet. Now we will be creating another machine which will be in private subnet. So for that machine we will be using same Amazon Linux AMI, same tier 2 micro, but we will be associating it with private subnet, and we will not be enable any auto sign IP. So let's launch it. So now if you go into the status check, you will be seeing two machines initiating. One will be using public subnet and second will be using the private subnet. So now you see we have two machines. One is public, one in public subnet. So the machine in public subnet has public IP and it is in public subnet. And machine in private subnet has no public IP. So now we will try to connect to the machine which is in public subnet. So here you see I am able to log in into this machine. So let me run update over it. So it is actually connecting to internet. It is actually extracting updates. Now let's try to connect to machine in private subnet. You see, I am not able to connect to the internet in this case. So what I need to do now, I need to copy this file into my public subnet and try to SSH using that machine into the machine of public subnet as a jump box. I have copied my PEM file into this machine which is in public subnet. Now I will try to log in into the machine which is in private subnet from this machine using that. So I am able to go into that machine which is in my private subnet using the machine which is in public subnet. So this completes our first part of how to configure NAT, which will actually start in second part. First we have put two machines in private and public subnet. Now we will create a NAT instance which will help public machine in private subnet to upload patches to connect to internet. So how that will work we will see in part 2. Please subscribe and like this tutorial and continue learning. Thank you.